up. May I please request Reverend Father Joe Ribello to come over and grace the occasion.
Good evening. Good evening. All right, you can just wave your hand. Okay, Father, they're all saying hi to you. I just wanted to say that today's generation, children don't have role models. Unke paas koi role models nahi hai. Unke paas koi heroes nahi hai. Inko lagta hai ki their only role models and their only heroes are people jo Bollywood mein aata hai. And that's not right. I just wanted to tell you today that jab main fifth standard mein tha, main Nala Supara mein aaya, aur mera parish priest, jo mera church ka parish priest hai, was Father Joe Ribello. And I just wanted to say, हर संडे जो मैं चर्च में जाता था और फादर एक 10 मिनट का चर्च में होता है एक 10 मिनट का एक स्टोरी या एक कहानी या एक लेसन एक मॉरल हमें सिखाता था हमें बोलता था और वो आई वुड से मेरे जिंदगी में बहुत मेरे में बदलाव लाया है सो माय रोल मॉडल वन ऑफ माय रोल मॉडल्स इज फादर जो रिबेलो एंड आई वॉन्ट टू टेल ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स मेरे सारे स्टूडेंट्स सेंट विली ब्रॉड्स के सारे स्टूडेंट्स आई वॉन्ट यू टू नो कि आपको आपके हीरोज और आपके रोल मॉडल्स अच्छी तरह से आपको चुनना है और आपको बाहर बहुत देखना नहीं है आपके आजू बाजू में देखो आपके पेरेंट्स को देखो कोई अंकल को देखो या कोई आपके कोई स्पिरिचुअल गुरु को देखो किसी को तो देखो एंड ट्राई एंड लर्न लेसन्स जो आप जिंदगी भर आप यूज कर सकते हो So Father Joe was the first person, I want to share this story with you. Father Joe was the first person who introduced me to a computer. 1991 mein father ke paas ek computer hota tha, bahut mehenga computer hota tha. Aur father mujhe, main fifth stand mein tha, aur father mujhe bataya, go use it. You come anytime you want, aur computer pe aap use karo. Aur wo chota sa ek incidence, mera life badal diya. और मेरा ही लाइफ नहीं बदला आज जब मैं स्कूल में जब मैं कंप्यूटर्स लाता हूं आप मेरे कोई भी स्टूडेंट को पूछ सकते हो माय चिल्ड्रन आर फ्री टू यूज एनी कंप्यूटर्स और एनी टेक्नोलॉजी विदाउट एनीबॉडीज इंफॉर्मेशन दे कैन जस्ट गो एंड यूज इट बिकॉज देयर लाइफ विल चेंज देयर लाइफ विल एब्सोल्युटली चेंज लाइक हाउ फादर जो चेंज माय लाइफ फादर वुड यू लाइक टू से अ फ्यू वर्ड्स
My dear Willy Broad and your mother Mary, my dear friends, pardon me not putting any title before them, because as Willy Broad told you, I knew him as a little boy, and I've seen him growing up wonderfully. And I'm so happy, Willy Broad, that today you are making such a change in the lives of persons. And I'm sure what your aim is to change the mindset of people will work wonders if we have to have a society which is going to be an enjoyable one. My dear friends, we know no man is an island. We have to interact with one another. We don't live alone. We either influence or are influenced by others. And so it is a choice that we have to make whether we should influence or be influenced. And who must influence us? As he just told you, is it the Bollywood? Is it the media? Is it the people or things of this world that are going to influence us? So that is the choices we have to make. I know Willy Broad is trying to help you develop true and lasting values. He's running these schools not just to teach you the 3 R's, reading, writing, and arithmetic, but he's wanting you to imbibe true and lasting values so that you become a better person and our whole society will become better persons, a better place to live in. My dear friends, as he spoke of role models, I reminded of this story of this little girl. She was very busy doing some painting and she was feeling a bit thirsty. So she said, "Mommy, Mommy, give me a glass of water." And her mother brought her that glass of water. She drank it and gave it back to the mother. And the mother said, "Mary, I've not heard the magic word." And she said, "Mommy, thank you." So my dear friends, we see how that mother was a role model for this child in helping her to say thank you. At the same time, there's another story of a little boy. He was there. His grandfather was with him. He was the only child. His grandfather was with him. And at table, the grandfather was quite elderly. And you know what sometimes happens with elderly persons? Sometimes they drop the food around at the dining room. And in spite of being told to be careful, some or the other, he would mess up the place before him on the table. So his father decided to have another small table for him at the side. And there he had his meals while the father, mother, and this little child were having it on the table. One day, the child had a small bit of wood and he was doing something with that wood. And the father said, "Son, what are you doing? What are you doing?" He said, "Dad, I'm making a small table for you when you get old." So my dear friends, we see how parents can become role models for us. So parents can have a good influence on us or a not so good influence in us. My dear friends, I may tell you another story too. And this is how a mother taught her child to see the good there is in others. There was this little boy who told his mother, he said, "Mommy, I'm going to the hills there just to have a nice time. It's so beautiful there, so fresh, so many birds, plants, trees, etc." Mother said, "Okay, darling, go." The little boy went. And then he was there shouting, "Hi there." And he heard the echo coming back, "Hi there." And he thought somebody else was imitating him. He said, "What is your name?" And he heard, "What is your name?" Again he said, "You're a bad boy." And he heard, "You're a bad boy." So he came back home and told his mother, "Mommy, I will never go to that place again. There's a bad boy who lives there. And he's all the time repeating what I'm telling him. He's calling me a bad boy." So the mother said, "Son, next time you go there, you say hi and tell him you're a good boy and you'll see what will be his reply." My dear friends, we know no one is bad. God has not made any junk. God has not made anyone bad. We all have some good in us. You know the saying, the best of us has something that's not so good. The worst of us have something that is good. So if we must see the good that is in others, and then we'll have a much better place to live in. So my dear parents, these are how you can help your children, giving them right values. No doubt the school does their part, but you need to do your part also. Remember, you have entrusted your children to the school. The school will do its part, but you have to do your part also. You know, you need two hands to clap. My dear friends, now to end, I'd like to tell you that God has given us a wonderful world. God has blessed us and surrounded us with lovely people, with the lovely things in this world, His beautiful creation. It is for us to develop. It is for us to preserve. It is for us to appreciate. It is for us to enrich God's beautiful world. And we can do this if we have the right education. And as I said, it's not the three R's, but it is a value-based education. And I'm so happy, Willie Broad, that that is what your aim in life is. I bless you. I ask God to bless you and your endeavor so that all these children will turn out to be the lovely person God has made them, loving and lovable. Persons who will always have a kind word, good thought, and a good deed for others. God bless you, my dear friends.